See, here we are discussing about the one of the note, okay, the potentiometer of the one of the important point here. They say a resistance R1 is connected in parallel across the cell in secondary circuit for which the balancing length is L1. If resistance R2 is connected in balancing length is L2, if R is the internal resistance of cell in secondary circuit. Actually, before this is the topic we discussing about in a the determination of internal resistance of cell using potentiometer. But that time we connected by the only one resistance. But here how many resistance are given by the R1 and R2? These two are connected in a secondary circuit. See here the diagram of this potentiometer. See in a potentiometer, this is considered the EMF of E and Plucky K and RH. This is called the rheostat R connected in series. See, this is called as the primary circuit. What is called here? The primary circuit. See the Plucky K. And in secondary circuit, we are connected by two resistance. See, this is the first resistance is R1 and the second resistance is R2. And this parallelly is connected by the cell of EMF is E. And this is considered the E1 and this is the EMF is considered the E. And the 3R is connected by any parallel combination. It is across is connected by the galvanometer and Jockey is connected to the manganing wire. See, this is called as the A and B is a manganing wire. This is called as the secondary circuit. See, this is the primary circuit. So which is comparing? See, that will be connected in a secondary circuit. In secondary circuit, how many resistance are there? The two resistance R1 and R2, and also there the battery of EMF E. Now this time, see here again, the R1 is connected to the parallel to the across is the cell. This is the parallel to the cell in secondary circuit. The R1 resistance is parallel is connected to the cell of EMF E in secondary circuit. So that balancing length how much is given by the L1. And R2 is also connecting the parallel to the cell of EMF E and its balancing length is L2. Then find out its internal resistance. See, that is the formula. It's directly we can write R1 by R2 into R2 plus small r by R1 plus small r is equal to L1 by L2. See, this is the formula of the R1 by R2 into R2 plus small r by R1 plus small r is equal to L1 by L2. See here, L1, L2 is the balancing point of length and R2 is the resistance of the second resistor and R1 is the first resistor of the resistance. And that is the formula for this one. We are discussing about the topic is the sensitivity of a potentiometer. See, the potentiometer is said to be the more sensitive. The potentiometer is said to be a more sensitivity if the measure less potential difference. So what is measuring by the other? Less potential difference or more accurately. The lower the potential gradient, higher the sensitivity. The lower the potential gradient, that is higher the sensitivity. That means the sensitivity is denoted by the S is, the sensitivity is inversely proportional to the potential gradient. See, what is the formula for the potential gradient? The potential gradient is nothing but a potential drop for unit length, that is S is inversely proportional to the V by L. This is the potential gradient. Now this denominator value is take the numerator, that is S is directly proportional to the L by V. from Ohm's law, what we can write, the V is equal to I into R, also is directly proportional to the L by I into R. So that means the sensitivity of potentiometer is directly proportional to its length, but inversely proportional to the potential difference, and also its resistance. The next we discussing about the note. If X is the length on the wire, see what is given by the, if X is the length on the wire at a position, at a position that is length of, how much is given by the X on the wire. L is the balancing length, then we have there the three conditions. So what is the first one? If X is equal to L, if this X is equal to L, no current flows in secondary circuit. See, when the both of them equal, that means there is no current flows through in a secondary circuit. Now the second, if X less than of L, current flows from primary to secondary circuit. Now third one, if X is greater than of L, current flows from secondary to primary circuit. See, this is the three of the conditions. Well, if X is the length of on the wire at a position, L is the balancing length, then X is equal to, that means the length on the wire is equal to the balancing length, that time there is no current flows in a circuit. Now if X is less than of L, now the current flows from primary circuit to secondary circuit. If X is greater than of L, the current flows from the secondary to the primary circuit.